지요!
할렐루야. Lift up your Bible.
배달출의 건강한 것으로.
I'm still preaching on the 10 principles that will lead you to manifest your glory the year 2018. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
May God help me for me to have the good wisdom to teach you, for you to understand all the 10 principles. Hallelujah. Last week I preached part one, the reason why we must respect our leaders and pray for them. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And I give you some wonderful revelations. Today I am preaching part two.
And I make
the reason why we must respect our leaders and pray for them
all.
Lift up your Bible. The word of life. Say Jesus.
Jesus.
I thank you so much.
Thank you so
much. I know.
Minimpa.
My life.
My bravo.
Is good.
Yeah.
Through your word.
And I'm one seminum.
I know I am blessed. Through your word.
And I'm one seminum.
As your word is coming to me.
One seminum.
Bless me more. Increase my wisdom. Increase my strength. Give me power to shine, to overtake this year, 2018. In Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Amen.
Sit down. I'm preaching part two. Hallelujah.
Amen.
The reason why we must honor our leaders.
But I didn't hear what say to me, share.
The reason why we must pray for our leaders. The reason why we must respect our leaders. I'll be giving you more revelations. It's going to help you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
We have so many leaders. No leader chose himself. Every leader who chose himself will be disgraced at the end. Before I preach, put this revelation down. It will help you to honor your leaders. Every great leader was once a loyal follower. And every great master was once a faithful servant. I take it again. Every great leader was once a loyal follower.
Now, can focus here,
and every great master was once a faithful servant.
Now, would be we work here, so we didn't create one.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
So, all the leaders you are seeing, they have all served before.
I can inform woman now, almost some pain.
Many have served with all their heart. And God has given them the anointing. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't just serve, but serve with the spirit of loyalty. Serve with the spirit of faithfulness. There are so many people who are not faithful by following their leader. They pretend to love their leader. Today, I'll be giving you more revelations. Put this one down. Number one, you must love your leader more than yourself. Wow. Today, I want to enter some areas. How am I supposed to love my leader more than myself? Amen.
Amen.
John 21, verse number 15 to 17. Let me talk about Jesus and Peter. You know that Peter was following Jesus boot to boot.
Not what the Jesus boot to boot.
And Jesus loved Peter so much.
Not Jesus what do Peter do.
And so every leader who loves his followers, he gives his followers revelation.
Now what can you phobia what don't you for you what would this?
And it will help you to shine. Let's see the word that God gave to Peter.
Yes, sir.
My son, are you there?
Yes.
Read for me.
John chapter 21 from verse 15. So when they had dined, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me more than this? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my lambs. 16.
Say amen.
Amen. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
So Jesus asked Peter.
Now Christ will be Petro.
Do you love me more than yourself?
Now what do me as no one?
He says, Lord, you know, I love you more than myself.
So would I say me dog?
Then Jesus said, if you love me,
Jesus said,
then feed my sheep.
And I mean,
go ahead.
16. He said unto him again the second time.
He said unto Peter again the second time.
Now what's the
Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my sheep.
Go ahead.
17. He said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonas, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Jesus said unto him, feed my sheep.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Jesus was talking to Peter.
Now Christ only Petro nekasa.
Peter.
See Petro.
Peter.
Petro.
Do you love me?
What do I mean, dear?
Love me more than yourself.
And the domestic one.
Amen.
Amen.
And if you say you love me,
nah, okay, so me dear.
Then you must feed my sheep. So he was telling him. How many of you love Prophet Kwega here? And what are you doing to support the ministry? Love is not just math. That's why Titus 1:16 said they profess to love God. But in work, they have denied him. How many of you have the desire that this church must grow? This church must go forward. How many of you? Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Why? Jesus realized that Peter claimed that he loved him.
Now Peter said, "Don't know."
But he was not doing what he's supposed to do.
Now we only hear the church say, "Oh yeah."
There are many of you,
don't know,
who said, "I love my leader."
Now me don't make any for.
But you are not in support of the vision of your leader.
Now we can't for this one. Who knows
that? That simply means that God, Jesus, was commanding Peter.
Now yes, you shall Peter.
I came to seek for the lost soul.
Ever heard when I hear that?
My mission is to seek for the lost soul. So if you say you love me, you must also feed the soul. You must do what I am doing. If you do that, that simply means that you love me. How many of you are doing everything possible to make sure breaking yoke become breaking yoke?
Breaking yoke.
Let me see your hand. So Jesus asked Peter three times, do you love me? Say, Jesus, you know that all those who are following you,
when they do it,
I love you the most. Then he said, okay,
see you.
If you love me,
then
feed my soul,
and
feed the sheep that are following us.
Hallelujah. Amen.
Okay. He asked me again. They were all there. Amen. They were all there. Then Simon.
And of course, Simon.
Do you love me?
What's that, Domi?
More than yourself?
Say
yes. Lord, you know.
Me don't pass.
Me following you.
Me do it.
I love you.
Me
more than myself.
Esine me ho.
That's okay.
You.
Then feed the sheep.
And
the third time.
That me answer.
Simon Peter.
Simon Peter.
Do you love me?
What do I mean?
Yes. Then Peter was offended.
And Peter.
Then why you don't ask my friend?
Oh,
and you're asking me.
You know?
So Peter was offended.
It's not Peter, no. It's
he was not the only one who was following him.
I want Jesus.
That why him?
Now then,
this question. Peter was offended.
And Peter.
Because Jesus knew.
Yes, we
that the work he has given him. One day,
that could be.
He's going to give him to his enemies. Or you deny him. Jesus knew very well that Peter would deny him. He's doing the work. He's following him. But his heart is not following him close. Hallelujah.
Amen.
If you love me, then feed the sheep. Peter,
Petro,
you are standing on the same foundation with me.
Now,
put this one down. Number two. Hallelujah. You are standing on the foundation your leader has built. So So when you fall, you will also fall.
You
are standing on the foundation of your leader. So when he falls, you will also fall. The book of Psalm 11, verse number 3. It doesn't matter how righteous you are. When you are following the leader, don't be self-righteousness. Sometimes those who are followers, some can say, oh, look, I'm good more than him.
But
the question is that if you are good more than him, are you chosen to be a leader? Have you forgotten that God has called him a leader, and you are standing on that foundation? So as long as you stand on that foundation, you must make sure you obey your leader. But when you fall, you will also fall. Read for me.
Psalm 11 verse 3. If the foundations be destroyed, what can the righteous do?
What can the righteous do?
I do not see any bit my head.
Say, praise God.
Hallelujah.
So the foundation is what holds the building.
Now, for permanent cloud dino.
The foundation
for permanent
is what holds the building.
In the cloud dino.
So breaking yoke. When we talk about the foundation of breaking yoke,
can't break you for permanent.
It's your prophet.
And you will do for.
So when your prophet go down right now,
it will do for confirma.
What can you do? What will your righteousness do for you? Say amen.
Amen.
You go down, you also go down. So doesn't matter who you are. When they laugh at me,
they'll
laugh at you also. It doesn't matter how righteous you are. It doesn't matter how decent you are. When your leader falls, you will also fall. So Peter don't know this. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Peter, forgotten that. When the leader falls,
okay,
the phone
is here.
You also fall.
So here, say,
praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
He gave him up. One day he was there. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Jesus.
Now yes,
and I'm going to phone
this
one.
Wait.
Jesus disciples.
Yes, you see I'm phone back on you.
Peter says.
And I petro do not pa
me.
No say me.
No.
And you won't so and yeah me.
A time is coming.
A baby by one.
Are you sure?
Ujidi.
When your leader is humiliated,
being
disgraced,
and you couldn't
when they ask you, where do you fellowship?
And for some more.
Assemblies of God.
Oh, me call Assemblies of God.
Am I preaching here?
Yes.
Peter denied Jesus. Why?
Adentia.
You are what he was going through.
Baby, oh,
when he agreed that he is a follower of Jesus,
so Jesus Christ needed for the
he will also be disgraced.
Praise
the Lord.
Hallelujah.
The day you understand
this,
you will never fight your leader. But you do everything possible to build with him.
But
when you go higher, you also go higher. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And so you are standing on the foundation of your leader. If he has not sacrificed himself,
1 pound which he.
Where will you stand to sing as a singer? Where will you stand to play tambourine as a tambourine
beater?
Where will you stand to do your ushering work? Where will you stand to be an elder? Where will you stand to say, I'm coming to be an
upcoming pastor?
Don't forget, you are standing on the foundation of your leader. And so don't wish his downfall.
Because
when you fall, you also fall.
Yes.
That was what people don't know.
And I don't remember him.
You see,
but who know?
He is a president.
Why your man Penny?
And those around him.
When they turn away,
they are talking.
No more kasa.
They are talking.
No more kasa.
Saying things.
No more kikansa.
About him.
We wanna say
talking.
No more kasa.
Many don't know.
Be bring him
say. After their president went down.
No more Penny call for more.
Their office was taken from them.
Yes, sir. Their
cars were taken from them.
No more cars. Their office was taken.
Their positions was taken from them.
And be
they think they are good armor.
Said,
as your master went out, you too, you must go down. So mature people don't talk against leaders, but they pray and honor leaders.
Put
this one down. All eyes are on your leader because he holds the light.
Now, anyone in
all eyes are on the leaders because they hold the light. Hallelujah.
Praise God.
He is holding the light. In the village, when we are traveling, it is only one person who hold the light, and the rest of them will follow him. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
And all of us following him, we are seeing the light, and it is the light he was holding. That's why all of us are following him. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
When the light goes off, all of us, we can't move again. When the shepherd is arrested, all the sheep was scattered. When the light goes off, you to your eyes goes off, because it's the eyes leading the way and all of you are following him. That's why you must honor him. When the light goes off, the book of Matthew 26 verse number 31, the target of the enemy is the shepherd, not you. The target of the enemy is the leader who is leading the company. The president leading the party, he is the target. That is why when you have the opportunity to follow a leader, don't wish his downfall. Pray for him. Because he holding the light, every storm, every wind blowing want to off that light. When it goes off, boom.
Everybody here is in trouble. You see the way it
that
is.
That's why when you hear somebody who want to off the light of your father, the person
Kanya
become your enemy.
When
that light goes off,
it will
affect me. So I will do everything possible to protect the light to be on. Hallelujah. Go ahead, my son.
Matthew chapter 26, verse 31.
31.
Then Jesus told them, this night you will fall away because of me. For it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered.
Praise the Lord. So you see, the shepherd
who.
So Jesus was telling them. So Jesus knew that he's about to die. They're about to kill him. And what will happen to the shepherd? The sheep. Hallelujah.
Amen.
So the enemy, their target and their plans is to strike the leader. The leader is the target. Our current president.
Your
the target is him. Not those they put in offices. It doesn't matter how educated you are in that finance office.
Uh-huh.
All the office they give. It doesn't matter how good you are in that office. When your leader goes down, your righteousness, how good you are, has no value again. Has no value again. Your leader, your light.
Tell somebody,
your leader, your light.
Pray
for your leader and keep the light shining. Protect your leader and keep the light shining. Honor your leader and keep the light shining. By so doing, God will bless you, and you will never become a victim to the enemy. May God bless you. Amen.